So carefully follow the verses of the Shikshashtaka, one after another, beginning with the glories of the Sankirtana, the glories of chanting Hare Krishna, the seven perfections to be achieved by chanting Hare Krishna, the first verse of the Shikshashtaka, seven perfections. Cheto darpanam arjanam. You can purify your heart of all the dust that is accumulated over millions of births, all the material dirty things, they can be cleansed by chanting Hare Krishna. Bhava mahadavagni nirvapanam. You can extinguish the fire of material existence only by chanting Hare Krishna properly. Bhava mahadavagni. This material existence cannot be terminated by any other method except bhakti. And in bhakti also, this process of chanting offenselessly the Hare Krishna mantra is the most effective in our age. And this process has been given to us with blessings by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Second perfection of chanting Hare Krishna. Extinguish the fire of material existence, the blazing fire of material existence. Third one, Shreya Kairava Chandika Vitaranam. You can experience the soothing relief due to the benediction of the holy name of Krishna. A holy name can satisfy all your desires, can give you complete satisfaction. You can experience soothing relief because that hankering and that lamentation under the spell of Maya, that's completely gone, and you experience a different kind of satisfaction, not the kind of material satisfaction. Vidyavadhu jivanam. Then transcendental knowledge is awakened in the heart. All the truths about the spiritual reality are automatically revealed inside the heart without any separate endeavor for acquiring spiritual knowledge. Simply by offenselessly chanting Hare Krishna, transcendental knowledge is awakened in the heart. This is the fourth perfection of chanting Hare Krishna. The fifth one is Anandambudhi Vardhanam Pratipadam. Anandambudhi Vardhanam. You can experience the taste of spiritual bliss, which is like an ocean which is ever increasing. How much bliss can you taste? As much as you want and more. There is no satiation. There is no limit to the supply of transcendental bliss. Anandamudhi vardhanaika nipunav kaivalya nistarakav. The six Goswamis of Vrindavan, they are glorified by Srinivas Acharya, that they are blessing the living entities to enable them to taste the ever-increasing ocean of transcendental bliss. Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. What kind of Sindhu? What kind of ocean is this? Bhakti Rasamrita? Ever increasing. That you can taste by chanting Hare Krishna offenselessly. Fifth perfection. Sixth perfection is Purnamrita Swadanam Pratipadam. Every step you can taste that nectar for which you are always anxious. Always you have been wanting. That's what Prabhupada discussed in this purport. The whole world is full of hungry living beings, and the hunger is for spiritual satisfaction. That hunger can be satisfied by offenselessly chanting Hare Krishna. Anandamburi Vartanam Prati Padam Purnam Tasvat Sarvatmasnapanam. And above all, this chanting of Hare Krishna, Sarvatmasnapanam, it is meant for everyone without exception. There is no question of whether it will work for me No. Sarvatmasna param. It is universal process. It's a universal process. It will work for everyone. It can satisfy everyone completely. It will make everyone successful. Param vijayate Shri Krishna Sankirtanam. So these seven perfections of chanting, beginning with that, study the verses of the Shashtaka and you can actually properly situate yourself to make progress, to be able to achieve the perfection of serving Krishna only for his satisfaction and not serving any material desires.